Greetings, Master Detective. The disappearance of George Pritchard 8 days ago has caused an upheaval in the royal family. Not only is he a valuable employee, he is also a dear friend of mine. His last known location was Huxley's boarding house. George has always been interested in obscure historical places. Though they are never without peril, I fear for his safety. The task of finding him falls to you, Master Detective. Sincerely yours, the Queen.
Come on, Sebastian! I can't start the van on my own!
I'm not wasting my time on that rattletrap of yours, Herr Benjamin.
Hey! Hey, you! Can you lend me a hand? Get into the driver's seat. I'll push and give you instructions. If you can't hear me, just honk the horn. First, push in the clutch. Just put something heavy on it. Quick! Hurry! Before the geospazer implodes! Put the van into neutral. Quick! Turn on the engine. The key should be around. Alright, now activate the wheels. Press the slider in front of the gear shift. Oh, yes, it's alive! And no one exploded! That's a win-win! Listen, I have to tell you... Oh, whoops! It's dinner time. I have to run.
And so, another soul wanders into Huxley's boarding house. I'm Mr. Harold, the landlord. Before you ask me anything, you must familiarize yourself with our house rules. They're strict, but they're effective. Many of our guests, whimsical as they are, find themselves much changed by the rules. Our patrons are all experts in their chosen field. Surely I'd remember a royal photographer. Of course, you're welcome to check the ledger yourself, Master Detective. Of course. I must be getting old. Mr. Pritchard was here. He checked in 8 days ago. How irresponsible of him to leave such an important document. Honestly, I'm sick to death of people forgetting their belongings. It happens all the time. I just started dumping them all in one place. This key opens the donation box at the Angel's Feet. If Mr. Pritchard left anything else behind, that's where you'll find it. Before I get back to work, there's something you should know. Mr. Pritchard did quarrel with another guest. I didn't want to interfere. Between you and me, the guest is a bit, obsessed with the paranormal. If anything happened to Mr. Pritchard, he's your man. Now, do excuse me.
have a seat, why not? It's not like I'm working. Between the writer's block and having to use that ancient typewriter, it's practically the Dark Ages around here. Sorry, that was a bit rude. I'm Rachel. I'm a writer from London. Mr. Harold called to tell me about a vacancy here. Hey, you're a detective. Maybe you can help me make some sense of this. I found it my first night here. This house is certainly full of mysteries, isn't it? I tried to solve it on my own, but I had to clear out all of that photographer's things when I arrived. Talk about a mood killer. Wow, would you look at those stones? They must be worth a fortune. Jacob obviously spared no expense. Jacob was a prodigy in the field of medicine. Who knows what he might have achieved if he hadn't killed himself? Rumor has it that the tower here is a marvel of clockwork engineering. If that's true, I suppose a lot of experts would do just about anything to study it. Oh, she died so young. Ben thinks that her ghost still haunts the house. It's absolute rubbish. Ghosts aren't real.
You're wrong. Meredith is still alive. Well, I mean, sort of. Her ghost is, anyway. I'll prove it.
Oh, wonderful. It's Ben. That's my cue to go to bed. Good night.
You know about the wax moth? That's quite good, actually. Because I need another favor from you. My mate George and I planted some audio bugs around the house. We were gonna listen to the recordings later. But he never showed up. He must still have my camcorder. So here, take my cassette player. It's dead as a doornail. But it's what's inside that counts, right? My van's out of power, but... Oh, is that the time? Sorry, I've gotta run. It's nearly bedtime.
I believe you are mistaken, Emily. Meredith's necklace must be in the restricted part of the house, on the first floor.
Those doors hide other marvels, dear Sebastian. Like all of Dr. Huxley's medical research.
Well, it seems the only way to see who is right is to open the doors.
We'll have to work together. Shh, someone's here.
Eavesdropping, are we? Such manners. Please excuse us. It's time for us to return to our rooms.
my shift would never end. Harold really bogged me down with repairs. What's more, that lunatic Ben asked me to fix a battery for him. I'm certainly not going to break my back on that one. Ben's friends always get the raw end of the deal. I'm only doing enough to keep Harold happy. It's only a matter of time now. Speaking of, it's nearly lights out. I'll see you later.
Thank you. Tonight, Mr. Pritchard, you will have a visitor from beyond the door. Do please stay in your room.
I've had enough of your rudeness! Leave me alone!
Mr. Harold, is that you? Please take care of my laundry.
Cut out that racket! I need my beauty rest!
I'm in my room. Totally not late this time.
Master Detective, please come in. I was just tidying up a bit before turning in. You'll never believe what I found by the bed. A secret compartment. I have no idea how to open it. Maybe you have a clue. Or two? Equipment to restore the footage. But no one is crazy enough to leave their room during lights out. Sorry, you're on your own.
Thank you.
Leave me alone! I don't care about your stupid rules.
No one breaks the rules.
Listen, there's not much time. The ghost took Rachel through the forbidden doors. They closed right in front of me. Rachel's scarf was caught in the hinges. I was too late. We have to help Rachel. You open the doors. I'll document everything. In there. Detective, behind you! Stop him!
Your curiosity will be your demise.
We're trapped. I knew that old man was up to no good. Going against what horror movies have taught me. We should split up and search for an exit. You take the left chamber. Rachel must be somewhere close. I'll take the center one. But beware. That ghost girl could be anywhere.
Thank you.
Ghost Girl! I finally got you in tape! Wait, what's that in your hand?
A lost soul has wandered into my home. I've been watching you. Welcome. There were others before you. Many of them wasted their lives in vain pursuits. Prove you're not one of them. Prepare my evening tea. Be warned. It must be perfect. Open the swan drawer. There's a recipe for my favorite herbal tea there. Now go.
Wonderful. It smells just right. Now I always read with my evening tea. Find my favorite poem in my hairpin. This is a special occasion and I need to look my best. I'll read you the poem before the full hour strikes. Be quick. The clock is ticking. Perfect. Now where is my poem? You're as competent as my first assistant. Quickly, braid my hair. The full hour is upon us. It marks the coming of the blast and my time of rest. I don't want to wake up with ruffled hair. I expect you to be here when I wake up. Don't you dare leave my side. A sight that can't be held by mother's eyes. It brings hurt that stigmatizes till a heart is shriveled. Bodies broken, their spirits torn. Lives viciously severed. A mother can only grieve and mourn till the mind is fevered. All that remains is memory and ash. As withered flowers, they wane in the season's flash. Till I am burdened with broken hours. Those words always bring back memories. With them comes such anger.
Thank you. Stop sneaking around, detective. You almost gave me a heart attack.
Loud noises woke us all up. The house was shaking. Everything was locked except for the forbidden doors. I couldn't let the opportunity pass by. If only I knew. Do you hear those screams? It must be Emily. She went to find Jacob's medical mumbo-jumbo. She must have found something dangerous. Now go. I've got a better chance of getting out of here alive if I work alone.
Thank you.
my eyes! Where are they? Who's there? Don't hurt me anymore, please. Detective, is that you? Look what they've done to me. They're insane. Harold held me, and Meredith took my eyes. She kept telling me I wasn't worthy of learning Jacob's secrets. That witch said age can't touch you. You'll always be a red-headed doll with a hairpin. I'll never forget her words. Eyes, my precious eyes. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Open up already! Detective! Of course I'm alive! I'm a professional after all. When Meredith appeared, my alarm clock went off and she went bonkers. I ran and roamed the house. Now she and Harold are locked in there with my camera. That footage is the only proof that Meredith exists and that Rachel was murdered. We have to get it. I never tested to see if my cameras are waterproof. Well, only one way to find out.
Thank you.
sorry, didn't see you there.
Thank you.
Congratulations, Detective. You've solved another case. Please bring our beloved George's remains home. I know this is soon, but it's a pressing matter. We've got a new case for you.